First, a WESH 2 exclusive.
A former corrections officer now locked up, charged with plotting to kill four people, including a federal agent. Good evening. I'm Jim Payne.
And I'm Martha Sagowski. WESH 2's Bob Keeling found out this is the second time this former officer is accused in a murder-for-hire plot.
There's enough twists and turns and intrigue in this story to be right out of a Hollywood movie script. But according to these federal charging documents we've uncovered, this alleged murder-for-hire plot was all too real.
Federal agents say this man, former corrections officer Michael Rudkin, had already started paying to have four people murdered, including the female inmate he pleaded guilty to sexually abusing while he was a corrections officer, plus his wife, his wife's boyfriend, and the federal agent who got him locked up in the first place. The feds say Rudkin approached two other inmates asking if they knew anyone who would carry out the murders for money. The person they brought in was actually an undercover federal agent. Charging papers say the phony hitman met with Rudkin inside the prison. Rudkin then took money out of his prison bank account, they say, and mailed it to the undercover agent, the first installment, investigators believe, of his murder-for-hire payment plan. Locals say it's scary to think Rudkin could use the mail to endanger innocent people on the outside.
I think when they're locked up, they should be locked up. They shouldn't be able to do anything until their time's up.
That's terrifying. You trust these people to protect your community, and then they turn to the other side. That's really scary.
In January, Rudkin was sentenced to 15 years for sexually abusing an inmate and plotting to have his wife killed. The feds say he even tried to delay the murder to make sure his wife's life insurance could be reinstated. Investigators say he started cooking up this new deadly scheme in June. Now Rudkin is facing new murder-for-hire charges and trying to retaliate against a witness. At the Coleman Federal Penitentiary in Sumter County, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.